Oh, am I going? Oh, right. Okay. Hello. I'm just breathing into the microphone like a, I don't know, a mouth breather, I guess. Hey, how's it going? This is Aaron. I am going to play some Super Nintendo now. I'm gonna play this game called Gods. Wow, I'm just looking at the screen now. Copyright 91, 92. Who could possibly be that old? I don't know. Okay, I remember when this game came out. I guess that's me. So, what am I thinking? Oh, you know what? I may have to reboot it because, I'm used to playing with the keyboard, but I've really started liking the controller because that feels more like the real Super Nintendo. I don't know if it will require a reboot for this controller to work, but give me just a second and I will find out. Don't know, a lot of people give the keyboard shit, and I'm like, eh. I'm used to it. Maybe I'm used to it because I'm old too, because a lot of these old games, like, I don't know, you know Commander Keen, my one viewer right now. You know Commander Keen, like, do you play that with a keyboard, don't you? I don't know if it has an ability to use like control pads. I'm not sure. I didn't play it that much, but I played it with the keyboard, so. Okay, that's set. Let's see if it's ready to go. Let me load a different. Whoa. What's going on here? Oh. Let me load a different game. No. Okay. Just give me one sec, then I gotta reset it. That should not be hard, though. Okay, good. It's set. So, I will play Gods. That's the name of the game. I'll just kind of let it play the intro and the music for just a sec. It's not long. It's kind of cool for 92. Huh. It's like his outfit. It's almost like Aztec or something. I don't know. The game itself doesn't explain it, but if you read the manual, basically what's happening in the story, it's not that important, but it adds a little bit of an interesting context. Basically, the gods, they've lost some sort of building or place or something, like an Acropolis, I don't know. And they want somebody to take it back, and they've offered a challenge that anybody that can take it back gets a one wish of their choice. And a human says, okay, I'll take on the challenge so long as you make me a god equal to all of you. And they're not happy about it. They're like, oh, we don't want to let this human in, but it's too late. They left it at an open call. So that's what your character is doing. He's like, kind of pissing off the gods by trying to become a god himself by taking back, their property that was stolen by, I don't know, I don't remember if it even says who took their. Oh, this is not me playing, this is just a demo. Okay, I'll start. But I thought that was a funny idea, you know? I kinda like how they wrote that story. Kinda like, the gods are actually kinda pissed off that a human took it up and made that wish. But now they have to keep their word. Okay. Oh, there's a hint. It's really bizarre. It's a pretty bizarre game, you'll pick that up. So, this Switch. Now, here's our first secret. It'll mention it a little bit somewhere later, but if you switch this flip back, flip this switch back to up, it'll be part of opening a secret. The secrets are really obscure and weird. So yeah, a lot of this game is just enemies spawning kind of nearby, and you have to pay attention knowing that that's probably going to happen. It's not always like that, but a lot of it really is like... Okay, so what do we got here? Oh yes, okay. Boom. And this is another... See, experiment with levers for bonus. So... I'll leave this down for now. We've got the treasure key. Every level has one, at least one treasury. And you can see I've got a score, and then below the score where it says 1975, that's how much money I have. Score is just score like any game that has a score. Ooh, this is the weird thing. Look, you can duck under those, but you can't shoot while you're ducked. It actually accesses your inventory when you try to shoot. What was I thinking? Anyways. And you can tell if you've killed the last monster in a group because they'll drop a gem. Sometimes they'll tease you by putting three monsters out and then leaving the fourth one not spawned for like 10 seconds or something, just to trick you. But if you don't see that last gem, you're like, that's not the end of it. Okay, these three levers, they're a puzzle. There's a way to get rid of that spikes, which is this always has to be up, and then these two have to be in a certain order too. Nope, that's not it. Is it this? Yep. Like, even the non-secrets can sometimes be really obscure. There's the treasure room for this level, but I will go to the secret here. That see, I put both of those levers up, I put them back into their original positions, and it opens up this little secret area, and it gives me a crystal that's worth 1500 gold, which is a lot. Then I teleport up here. I don't know. This probably seems annoying to people, a lot of people, but I kind of find it amusing. I kind of like these bizarre secrets. You don't necessarily have to find them, which is... Oh, hang on. Which is what I kind of like. Well, I don't know. You know what? I think if you're really going to beat the game, you pretty much have to know quite a few of the secrets. It's maybe a little unfair, but you know what? You couldn't buy that many games at a time back then, so this was like the only game you were playing at the time, other than maybe one other one. So, fine, if it... You know, if you had to work a little harder, it didn't really matter. I love his little swagger. Little arms swinging when he's walking super fast. Whoa, that guy dropped a spear. Okay. Okay, so that's a secret button there, and if you can push four of them, you get a secret towards the end of the level. See, now, they stalled a little bit on that last guy. God. Too many of those things. I got the... I don't even know what that's called, but it explodes. Oh, okay. In the lower left there, my health is almost gone. I can't... If I get hit by one more thing, I'm dead. I've never figured out how to get up there, and I don't know if you actually can. I think it's just a tease. Well, I don't know. Maybe there's some super obscure way to get up there that I haven't figured out. Use the trapdoor key to fall down the trapdoor. Okay, I always die here. So the enemies are interesting. They're quite varied. Sometimes they appear and they're weak and they don't shoot. Sometimes they shoot beams that you can duck. Sometimes they shoot heat-seeking missiles. Sometimes they're super buff and you have to hit them with 100 shots, but they're slow. And the thing is, they all look the same. You just have to try it out, and if you shoot somebody like 50 times and they're not dead, you're like, oh, it's one of those. Okay. So they're just kind of... let's see. I'll try not to swear. So they're just kind of messing with your head, you know? Like, this guy that looks the same as all the others. Is he tougher? Is he gonna shoot? I don't know. There's a trick to this. One of these levers activates a trap. One of them will open up that gem. See, that guy was super tough. And they're shooting heat-seeking missiles. So pick up the key. Here's the weird thing. You've got this four inventory slots down here. Trapdoor key, ceramic pot. But you can only keep three equipped. Because the thing is, whatever the cursor is on will drop. And so what you have to do is pick up an item and then move to an empty slot. But if there was something in that slot, it would drop, so you can only carry three out of the four. It's weird. I don't know. I think they're just being weird on purpose, just to make it different and interesting. Which, it actually works that way. Oh, that was the booby trap. Oh! Oh dear, I'm at zero lives. I'm wondering if I should cheat to get unlimited lives. I'm usually not this dead at this point. That's really bad to have no lives left at this point. That's like terrible, actually. Oh, and I'm probably gonna die because of those guys that just appeared. Oh, I don't know what to do. You know what? I'll save state it. How about that? Because you watch, as soon as I step on this teleport gem, I'll step directly on top of one of those guys. Oh, that was close. Okay. So, I'm good. I'll just play it straight then. I think. Okay. I don't know if you were reading the messages, but one of them says collect more than one pot to get a bonus. Oh, see, super tough guy, super wimps. Just, I don't know, it's weird. Trapdoor key, I probably won't actually get use out of that. Oh. Oh, whoa, he shoots fast. I could die at like any second here. Oh god, I gotta be careful. So, treasure chest, but I need a treasure key for that. Look at that! Okay, free guy, great. $1,000 gem, great. This might be the key that opens that. Yes! A few, like a couple thousand bucks in money. But see, this is like, if you didn't really try that hard to get that secret, you're short like a thousand bucks or more. And you can actually buy power-ups for the next level. It's the way the Bitmap Brothers does games. It's like, you don't have to find secrets right away, but you probably will get through about half the game. And if you do find all the secrets, then maybe you can beat the game. Seems unfair, but like I say, you didn't buy 20 games at a time, so like, this was it, you know? You had one other game. I mean, they were all 40, 50 bucks, no matter what, so... let's see, was that the exit key? No. So, see, since I brought two pots, I get a key and a diamond. Or a gem. Of some kind. And I think that's all I can do here. Wow, I'm about dead. And then we complete the level. Ooh, extra life. Cool. You can get a few extra lives, enough to keep you going for a lot of the game. This store idea is pretty cool. These are your shot arcs. This will shoot fairly high and low. This will shoot everything in the middle. It's a little odd, but whatever. Let's see, what does that do? Increases weapon power. Oh, okay. 6,000, no. I think I'm gonna upgrade it because these knives, power 1, throwing star, power 2. So I'll just buy 3 of those, because you can have a maximum of 3. How much is that? I need to buy food, to be quite honest. Well, this heart should refill everything. Value 4,000. Ooh, didn't. Okay, how about this, as well as this loaf of bread. Okay, how about this apple? Okay, how about this lump of meat? That'll do. So now I got throwing stars. Hint, the lightning bolt. Hint, will help defeat the guardian. Oh yeah, and then there's like, you know, I was saying enemies are a little bit different each. Like, this guy up here will only walk back and forth, but then there's some guys that will look exactly like him that will also leap at you. And you don't know which is gonna be which. Well, I do because I played the game too much, but typically speaking, you don't necessarily know. Ah! Jeez. Oh, see? Ah, man, and they got me too. Okay, can I hit that guy at all? Oh, good. Oh, a gem? Really? What? Oh, it's a teleporter gem. Huh, I've never got that before. I don't even know how that triggers. Everything triggers for a reason, but, shit. I don't know why that one did. Oh, okay. This is a hard, hard part. I'll explain later why it's so hard, but, or do I even really need to? There's this guy here that spits, and then there's three guys that appear here that spits. And if you don't shoot this target real quick, you really pretty much have to do it. You pretty much have to kill that bullhead first, or else you're screwed. I'm screwed anyways, I got one hit point left. Okay. Can I go down? I mean, I've got some stuff to collect. This is probably gonna kill me if I fall down. Here we go! Oh shit! Right into some spears! Well, yeah, I think that will kill me. Jeez, why am I back up here? You know what? I actually think it's only like one or two gems. Nice to get them, but... Oh well. Oh, now I got Fireball. So see, I got a new little thing there to add. Oh, heat seeker. Okay. Oh, jumper. I feel like... do I want to go down there? Jeez, really? Come on. Ah! I've got one life left. I have to be super careful. There's some health. Oh, okay. To be more accurate, I've got two lives left. It'll say zero, and that's technically my last life. Seems like there's a secret here, because doesn't that look like you can get over to the right? Well, whatever. That's one I haven't found. Ah, good, another fireball. Oh. Bonus gem for 100,000 points. Yeah, you get little bonuses like extra money and extra lives for just for getting a high score. I don't know. I guess it's not different than arcade games. It just seems like this type of a... Oh, jeez. Ah! No problem. I know what's going on here. I'm not stunned by not being prepared. Okay. Uh-oh. I've hit the volume button, apparently. Hang on. What have I done? Okay, there. At least, I don't know if it stopped for the audience, but at least for me, my volume disappeared. Okay, that guy is jumping too much. How about I just Super Mario that fucker? I mean, that guy. I don't swear. So this is a weird part. Trapdoor key. Nail it. Okay, you see I jumped over there and got all these gems? Here's the weird thing. If you come over to this area in any other way, like you teleport over there, the gems won't fall. So these are like some really weird secrets, like... Just, I had to play a few times before I figured out that's how it worked. Like, that is the most bizarre thing. But whatever, I... Kind of interesting anyways, right? See, now I hit the lever. Make sure I get these guys. Ooh, and some health. Oh, all the health. Great. So, treasury key. There's usually just one treasure in each place. Teleport key. Sometimes there's teleporters. And world key is for the level exit. So, normally falling really hurts you, but since there's a power-up at the bottom that gives you invincibility, you can trick it like... Like, I took no damage because I picked that up just before I landed. World key, and that lets you exit to the next level. Now, what was this? Is this the treasury? Yes. Now, I've got a fireball amongst all that. I don't actually need to use the teleporter at all. It just puts you back, like, right about here-ish, which is a little silly. Some teleporters are a little bit more useful. Oh, did you see that little maneuver there? Tricky stuff, huh? Oh. Oh, whoa. Jeez. They just really mess with you. So that trapdoor key for the trapdoor. And there's the world exit. Okay. First boss. This one's not... This is one of those weird bosses, if you've ever played a game where they... It's really easy to avoid all their damage, but if they hit you even once, you're absolutely fucked. I mean, screwed. I mean, in trouble. I don't know. I think I put an adult disclaimer on this channel, so screw you guys. Screw you guys if you don't like swearing. Fuck you guys. Oh, see? Whoa. See, it's not too hard to stand in the right place as you're shooting him, but if he hits you with even one of those, you just take, like, massive damage. So the trick is, oh, not to get hit. And it's always the exact same length, so very, very predictable. Oh, yeah. Money, 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 money. Oh, this is our first shop. No, this is the second shopkeeper. Okay. Shop post and shaman's the shopkeeper. Okay. What do we have now? It varies level to level. A few things are introduced every time. Magic X. This thing's actually handy, but that's all the money I've got. Alright. And then I'll buy some bread. And an apple. Ah, this silly game. 650? Sure. Anything over here? No. Level 1 complete. So, the temple. It might seem kind of short, but that's especially because I got really good at it, but this is about a fourth of the way through the whole thing. Okay. Secret button. Like, to do as much stuff. Ooh, extra life, I'll take it. To get as many secrets and to get as much stuff as I have right now. Like, takes a lot of experimentation and practice, so I wasn't necessarily burning through it quite this fast to begin with. Ah, this is a weird spot. Those things kill you really fast, but then there's also invulnerability right there. See that? Halfway dead. So this is a weird secret. You cannot pull that lever right now. You have to wait till invulnerability disappears. Okay, and then when you do, go ahead and pull the lever. And it makes a thief appear. Now the thing is, the thief, boom, he's more interested in a key that's over there. He'll pick it up. Because thieves pick up anything that they see. And that's just weird to figure out, because at first I was pulling the lever, and the thief would come and I'd stand right here. But the invulnerability stretches out far enough that it kills him. I'm just like, wow. Damn, that's obscure. Just through experimentation, I kind of figured that out, you know? And no, I didn't look it up. I actually did look up a couple things, so there's probably a couple points where it's like... I can't brag, because it's like, yeah, okay, I really did look that one up. But not that one. Boomp. Vulnerability even makes it so you can fall from unlimited height. Good old health. Whoa. Now this is just back here. Oh, these snake jars. Once you destroy them, little snakes fall out. Don't tell Scripto I'm killing the snakes. Just tell him they're evil snakes, and he'll be okay with it. Unless he is an evil snake, I don't know. chest key, which will open up the blue chest. Money! What is this? Nothing. Oh no, I already tried that. Okay. Are you still with me? I'm seeing your name and stuff. This is a gem we actually have to pick up. Ice gem. I think that treasure key is just a backup key if you didn't happen to get the first one. Oh, jeez, come on, man. Give a guy a break. Oh, I got wasted. I got trashed. That's bad. Like other Bitmap Brother games, or like most games from the 90s, you really just can't afford to get hit at all, because you don't get unlimited continues. Once these three guys are gone, game over, start from the beginning. This one doesn't even have, you know, the ability to continue. Like, your lives are your continues. Oh! Fucking A. Really? How did that happen? Ah, jeez. Oh, there's a snake jar. Am I hitting it? Barely. I'm gonna have to get up there. You probably noticed that I'm shooting really high and really low, which makes it harder to hit those little snake dudes. That's why I keep falling back here. But it makes it really easy to hit things up high. No surprise, I guess. So here's where our gems come into play. Even the non-secrets are almost like secrets. Because you see those three... Well, two right now. Oh, jeez. Ah! Man. This really is no good for snakes. Ah! Okay. So you see those two buttons up there, and then there's a third. There's three gems, and... Boom! Drops the first thing. I don't know, I kind of wish there was maybe a modern game or two that just did these bizarre kind of secrets, just for fun, just to experiment and see if you could find them. Oh, those flying things dodge bullets, I hate them. Whoa, that's a tough one. So tough. Was there anything else over here? Huh. So there's our second gem. Drop it a little lower. I don't know, I could probably think of some other 80s or 90s games where the secrets are just as weird and obscure. And you might think, oh, that's lame, I don't want to work that hard. I don't know, it's actually kind of fun when you're just messing with it, and you're like, I gotta figure out how to get here, I gotta figure out the secret. There it is, now I got the world key. I'm actually gonna drop it in this key, just leave them here for a sec. Talking about secrets, the door lever that opens this door, push it again, and then push it again. There you go! And now we're in a completely secret area that you can only get to from that. Good, and I picked up a better arc. It's not nearly as intense. That's a teleport gem that takes you back, so we don't want that. it? Okay. This is a little obscure. You have to just keep running like you're doing a 100-yard sprint, because otherwise you can't get to the end. You'll see what I mean. That guy's too tough to kill. This guy, you just want to get past. Ooh, grab the free life, grab the health. Oh, well, at least I got everything. I died, but I did get everything in there. But if I wouldn't have got everything, the game just gives you a big fuck you. It says, yeah, there's all sorts of good stuff in there, and you died, and now you can never go back. It's pretty harsh. Okay, so if I use a key, so that's the world key, so that'll exit the level. Ah, these little assholes. Okay, I don't have a key for that. Ooh. Treasure room. Look at all that gold. Oh, I hate these guys. Come on! Expose yourself. There we go. Because they can fly into the background. Like, I can't shoot past this wall, but they could fly past that wall. It's just assholes. Alright. Isn't there a key here? Yes, there is. Good. Doesn't open that chest? Huh. What key opens that chest? I don't know. Hang on. There is. I think I've got the key to that chest now. Yes. How come I'm missing that other key? That's weird. Go have a look. Oh, you know, I shouldn't have done that. That's actually a bad idea. Was the key over here, though? Nope. Ah! Because it uses them automatically. Whatever. I'll just keep going. It's not the worst, most detrimental thing, you know. That is a chest key. Oh, that's right. That's the one I said was the backup. Hmm. Usually I get both of those chests. I don't know how I missed that other key. Oh well, I'm not gonna worry so much about it. I'll just exit. Hang on. Careful, long falls are not good. That's the exit. World 1 complete. I mean, I could beat this game. I can probably beat this game within about an hour. I've been playing for an hour. I was gonna play for half an hour. Who cares? Oh boy. Oh no! See how brutal this game is? It's not like I get hundreds of lives. That was like a third of my lives. That brings me a third closer to game over. That is bad. You can't just fuck around and make little mistakes like that. I mean, I still might be able to beat it, but like you just really have to play it close to the wire. Jesus, I about fell off there too. What the fuck? Oh. Hmm. Thank you. they try to make these spawns as like inconvenient as possible. Know what I mean? Just really like to mess with you. Ooh. Hint, the chalice's reveal. Well, at least he had health. The chalice's reveal key. Here's they really mess with you. If you fall down there, you get injured. The only way not to get injured, because it's a long fall, the only way not to get injured is to run, jump, grab the ladder. This is like, really? Come on, guys. I don't know. I guess if you own two games, might as well learn how to play these little things. Let's see. Okay, talk about an obscure secret. So what we have, pulling this lever does nothing. Pulling this lever, now I have to pull it from a place where I won't fall. Right about there. Foomp. That, if I went down that hole, it's instant death. But now, this one will open. That's not instant death. Okay. See? It's like, why? I don't know. I guess you just fuck around long enough and you're just like, okay, I get it. And that also gives me a chalice. Not strictly necessary to get this chalice, so I guess that's it. It's more like a secret. You only have to pick up, like, one of the, or two of the chalices out of the three. Yeah, alright. Whoa, jeez. Ooh, health. I'll take it. Oh, yeah, it gives me the health, and then it spawns a bunch of enemies. Oh, that's lovely. Stupid assholes. I need to let some of these keys go. Oop. There's the last chalice. And, let's see. This gives us two secrets, sort of. It gives us... You know what? I need to drop the chalices. Gives us two keys instead of one for bringing all three chalices in here. But the other secret is, if you leave the chalices in here, it gives you two more secrets. I just mean... It's like irritating, but kind of interesting at the same time. I don't know. Just weird, you know? See? There's two more secrets. The key and the chest that it goes to. I don't know. Oh, damn. I really shouldn't have done that. Extra life, yay! Actually should grab that. Takes me back to here. I've got the treasury key. Just a bunch of free money. You know, the treasury key is not always obvious. That's one that they don't necessarily hide in absolute secret, but if you're not paying attention, you don't necessarily find it. Okay, so we close that trap door. This closes the trap door just below. Oh. Same here. Look how fast that last one's shooting. It's ridiculous. Alright. Way we're not falling too far, I'll get the different. Yikes! Let's see, I don't actually think I need to use this teleporting door. Doesn't take me anywhere special, just. Oh, damn! I can't be affording to lose lives like this. I guess I can! Because that's exactly what I'm fucking doing! What are you gonna do? Whoa. I think this is all you can do on this level. I've cleared out everything. As far as I know. Damn it. Phew. You still there? Shopkeeper. I've got a lot of money this time around. Increases weapon power. Okay, so that increases weapon power until you get to the boss, and then it dissipates. And then you can buy it again. How much was this? 15? How much are these spears? They're like a lot more powerful than what I'm using. 17. It's kind of funny though, the way this game fucks with you. Like these spears, you can spend all the money in the world on these, and you start the level out and it puts like a weaker weapon in front of you and is like, got a problem with that? And you have to pick it up and throw away all the stuff you just bought. It's just like, you assholes. So, I guess it helps to know the game. And I can't actually remember if that's going to happen in this case. I'm trying to remember what's this next level. I don't know. Maybe I'll just get one of these. Maybe get the slight weapon increase. 20,000, wow. Alright. Some of the cheap shit. So here we have a broken up mural. And pieces of a mural. Mosaic, excuse me. Boop. Hint, repair the mosaic to please the gods. Alright. Trapdoor key. Boom, there it goes. Okay, so this is obscure. You can take. You're not ever locked out of it, but, like, to open this fake door here, you go. You have to pull this right lever to move it over to the right. Then you have to pull this left lever to move it up. And then you have to walk by this left lever and pull it again to open the door. It's just, I don't know. It's all right. That's kind of why some of these secrets are obscure. Because I do remember there is a secret where there are about three levers. And if you have, like, the left and right levers up and the middle lever down, it puts an obstacle that won't let you through a hallway. And the hallway's not mandatory, but it's sort of secret, but it's like, the game just gives you this big middle finger and just says, fuck you, you're not going there. If you happen to pull the middle lever first, it's just like, haha, you'll never get in there. It's like, oh my god, really? Here's a little trap. Oh, look, a key. Well, that's nice. Oh, and an enemy. I don't know why, but dropping off the skull in this pot gives you a mosaic. I have no idea. And it also causes these herbs, this jar of herb to spawn. I don't know why. And you actually drop the herbs off in this room. Ooh. I'll give you a mosaic piece. Oh, door shut behind us. See, piece of globe. Now we can get out. Kill the snakes! Ah, put the globe in its place. It's a shark! And it gives us that. Oof. Okay. Find the candle. That's a good hint. Thank you. Trapdoor key. Ah, yes, I can't get in there yet. No, that's not for that. Okay. Hint, return levers to get across. Oh, I remember. It's over here. It's this one. Good, now I've got three spears. Or did I already have three? I don't remember. You can have up to three of anything. I think for sure that goes there. Yes. Oh, God. Oh, snakes! Ah, I forgot. This part is... Oh, God, it's harsh. Thing. See now what it was saying about return levers? You take all these and you push them back up. There's a damn near invincible guy. No, okay. That wasn't too hard then. Tougher than normal at least. Too many things. But, you know what I was saying, it makes that platform appear if you put all the levers back up. Why that platform? Why levers? Why anything? I have no fucking clue. Because, that's why. Alright, and why did that door key appear out of nowhere? I don't know, but now I get stuff. I mean, you kind of get the idea. I don't think that door key appears unless you've, like, collected everything up to that point. But why that even? I don't know. I don't really know how it all makes sense. I don't think it's really supposed to, other than... get to understand what things do what. And a gold relic. Whoa. Okay. That was close. Let me know if my mic cuts out. I've been having issues bumping the mute button. And then I just end up talking to myself for like 20 minutes. And then I have to ask, did you hear anything I said? No! Cool. Ah! I cannot afford to die with such stupid shit. Like, if I died on something epic, okay, what can you do, but just these dumbass enemies, I can't keep dying on that stuff. Hint, illuminate the study to end the world. Okay. That makes sense, somehow. Whoop. Extra life for 500,000 points. There's a snake down there, isn't there? Yeah. Ah! This game just loves to mess with you. Nice try. Door key, room key. I think that activates this door. Yes! And now I've brought the icon back to here. Gives us a dragon gem. Drop this. Stolen from the dragon. Let's also take the candles. Now here's the thing. Okay, I'll just give you a demonstration. We take one of the candles and the gem. Oh, okay, I guess it does work. So I guess so long as you take one candle. If you don't pick up any of the candles, this key won't appear. Just... okay. Now this dragon gem is real special. I'll tell you when I'm not so busy. It's a secret. I mean, it's already a secret to pick it up, but if you know how to use it, it's a secret. And honestly, I feel... well, I'm gonna sound lame. I feel kind of cool because I figured out how it actually works. I'm like, if it was stolen from the dragon, does that mean the dragon's gonna react to it? And it turns out it makes him the easiest boss in the game. Because check this out. Well, let's see. Yeah, check this out. Here comes the boss, but I put the gem right there. He won't move past it. He stands exactly right there. Like, wow. That's it. He actually has another attack that he uses too, but he's not... he doesn't ever get close enough to use it. We'll just go like this and... don't need the gem anymore, but I'm gonna pick it up. Money, money, money! By the pound. Now this will reduce damage for all the levels up until the boss, so I think if I bought it now, it would actually get rid of it as soon as I left this area. I'm not sure. Same with this power potion. Which means... I should probably just buy some health ups. Sure. Level 2 completed. And now we are in the labyrinth. Should I play? Let's at least play one level of the labyrinth. And then maybe I'll put it off till next time. But this is about halfway through the game now. Maybe a slightly more. They just... I don't think there were, like, any 20... You know, well... I don't think there were any, like, 60-hour epic games at the time. People didn't do that. It just wasn't a thing. I don't know if they could've... Well, no, that's not true. There were actually a few. But they still weren't really, quote, a thing, you know? Still a little bit rare. Just not as many. Hint, bombs destroy traps and hives. Oh, come on. I don't think there's anything up here. Unless it's a secret. Time bomb, power 20. So here's... I mean, it sort of spells it out for you, so it's not that, like, that secret. But you drop a bomb in there. Oh, oops, I missed. Drop another bomb. Those hives usually take a hell of a long time to kill. Woo! This kind of sucks. Those maces are not... They're about half as good as what I was carrying. But they can break breakable blocks. So I'll roll with it. Jeez. Oh, I'm so glad that I didn't die before picking that health up. I would have been ranting and raving and I don't know, breaking all sorts of stuff. Ah! Really? Alright. I say, I can't be getting hit by that stuff. You gotta play this to the wire. Well, I don't know. Two lives is okay at this point, but frankly, I'd rather have a lot more because it gets harder and harder. And there, I just did it again. Why the fuck not? I mean, if you're not trying to get to the end, you can really screw around a bit, but, like, me, I've been to the end, so I kind of want to, like, every time I play, I'd rather get to the end. Oh, which one of these is the good one? This is a really, weird part of the game. Shit. I might have fucked myself. I'm gonna save it, state it. You can actually get permanently stuck in this area. And I don't mean you get a game over. I mean it's like... You literally... All the doors are locked and you only get one chance at the key that unlocks a door. Because it's in one of these teleport rooms and you only get to try to teleport in once. If you teleport in and don't get the key, there we go. Or don't get what you need to get the key. game just gives you the bird, and it doesn't even tell you you're stuck. I just walk around for like 10 minutes, and I'm just like, oh, I really, really am stuck. And there's actually one other place I can think of that does that. I'm just like, what assholes? At least it's not like around every corner, but it's like they actually did that. Come on. Oh, give me the cheap shot. That's fucking great. That's the key. Like, okay, that one room that had all those yellow bats in it. If I were to trigger that and then leave the room and then come into this room, or if I were just to exit right now, I am permanently stuck. This is the only key that will take you anywhere. You actually have to get the treasure key in this level. If I were to exit it, I have no way of getting back to that key. It's just like, wow. I'm not even sure it was like an error, like if somebody was playtesting, they're like, oh, we just missed that, you know? I think they totally did that on purpose. Just to get your goat. It wouldn't surprise me. Ah, stop doing that! Jesus! I'm not mad. I'm not mad! I'm only furious! Probably won't be winning the game now. I can't lose that many lives over that many stupid things and expect to get anywhere. These things are interesting. Potions. So see, we got a thief up there and he took the key and he's just like, nah, that's my key. Well, potions attract monsters, so we'll put this down, and he's like, oh, let me have that. Boom! I don't want to leave yet. I think that's the exit to the level. I think? No? I have no idea. I wasn't paying attention. No, that's not the exit to the level. That can't be the exit to the level. Yeah. Hint, watch the ceiling in the treasure room. You got it. So now I got the high-low arc. See there up on the ceiling? That's what maces are good for. I'm just gonna keep shooting because I know they just keep coming. Yay, world key, yay. A sort of secret, not really. So while you've got the high-low shot, grab that. And that's it. World 1 complete. Oh, I need a glass of water. Whoops, I'm good. Okay. Shopkeeper. Now you can buy a familiar. They're pretty cool, but they seem to like suicide a lot more than I wish they would. And then they're gone, and that's like an expensive $30,000 right there. I'd rather have this for what? $20,000? Or the shot power. I'm really not sure which is better. I guess if I play like shit, maybe I should get the defense. And then with my 13,000, let's finish off with some health. Thank you. Yeah, I think this stage that's coming up. Oh no, not this one. I think the next one. I really hate. Okay, so there's a mandatory pickup. Like, I cannot go past this area without picking it up. But this one's actually a little bit more fair because it spawns a thief. And if you let him be, he'll actually take it away from you. Now, I'm gonna miss out on those two gems, but that's okay. I really don't want that lesser power-up. But even then, that's sort of a secret. Normally, you would just kind of be like, fucked. Well, not a huge secret. That's one a lot of people figure out. Get to the top with max energy for a key. This I had to memorize and try a whole bunch of times. It does not... Here, I'll show you. This is... You have to do this exactly. Pick it up, jump before you get shot at, pull the lever, and I didn't get it. I'm not getting the key, and I'm not getting the chest. Otherwise, the key would drop right here. You have to get to the top with full health. This game is just so full of fuckery. Ah, man. It is harsh. I don't think that's a fireball. I think... Oh, yeah, that was a fireball. I'm stupid. Actually, the fireball is a secondary weapon, and there's... If I would have bought one of the other secondary weapons, I might rather have that instead. Because the fireball replaces it. But you're right, that was a fireball. I was thinking for some reason it was a different thing. I've already got fireballs. Oh well, whatever. There is value in not picking up stuff sometimes, though. Hi, little friend. Fire gem. That takes care of that. Was there something down here? Oh, just that. Why am I thinking of... No, I'm thinking of a different level, actually. Okay. How come the floor didn't drop? Normally, at this point, the floor drops. I don't know why it didn't drop. I'm a little concerned, to be quite honest. I think one of the things that appears down there you absolutely have to collect. Really? Okay, this is the one. If I pull this middle lever, it blocks off this area permanently. If I pull that lever, it puts up a booby trap that will instantly kill me. Okay. How about this? Okay, good, good, good. But then how do I open up the area? No? Okay, good, that opened it. And that gave me the gem, too. So, we can walk through it. But like, the first five times you play this game, you're like, I don't know. How the hell was I supposed to know that? You're not. You're supposed to just play it 100 times. Ice gem. That's actually really bothering me. Why did that not open? I think it's mandatory. Nope, okay, because I've been down there. Okay, whatever. I don't know what I'm doing. Okay, you open this door. Now see, there's some gems back here, and the game would have you believe you have to have the thieves fall down and bring them to you, but really? Let's pull this lever a second time. Oh, god damn! Fucking hell. Let me guess, you're gonna jump down here. Die! I'm okay. There's nothing wrong. I'm perfectly calm, I'm just acting. I'm just acting fucking furious. No, I'm not. I'm actually quite mad. Come on down. Well, at least I got an extra life. Good. Fucking game. Yay. Now, I don't know, maybe it's not that bad, it's short, but this is my least favorite level. Oh, God. Okay, so I'm about dead, one more hit, but there's a guy down here with health. Let's see if I can do it. The ironic thing is I have to stand right next to him and kill him. Yep, there it is! I would have not lost a life, and I would have had two lives for the next level, but... Nope! Had to die right on that guy. Hint, pull the lever on the right quickly for a bonus. Okay, and at least that one's fair and kind of pointing it out straightly. Pull there, and then quickly pull there, grab the life, move. Because... what's not going to do it? Axes! There's an axe right there. Boom. I don't know what that button does. Gotta pull that lever real quick, because an axe appears! Isn't that nice? I'm not entirely sure what that lever does. I think sometimes it covers up the enemies above. Okay. I don't think I can actually get to that gym. So, we get down here. Boom, 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 boom. More axes. This game is fucking crazy! Need the treasure key. Okay, trapdoor key. And... get the key in 15 seconds. The trick is, see those two guys? If you don't get the keys in 15 seconds, they drop early. I guess there's worse things, like at least it doesn't kill you instantly. I think that's it. Oh, and now the boss, and you can't cheap shot this one, so here we go. This one's interesting in that he doesn't do that many dangerous things, but he does that. And then if you're on the right side of him, that's the weirdest thing. He's like, "You cannot be on the right side of me! That offends me!" And then he hops around like a madman. I don't know what that means. Maybe that's a Minotaur thing. Ooh! See, he's not that deadly, but once he pins you in the corner, you don't know when to run under his legs. You just have to really watch it carefully. And if he touches you, you die. See, here we are again. Oof! Got it that time. Ah, you're on the right side of me. That is not okay. Ah. Oof! ugly death. Is there a key? There must be a key. Oh god, tell me there's a key. Oh, okay, it's at his feet. Ah, summon the shopkeeper. Again. Just that familiar just really isn't worth it. It's one of those things that's like, that's neat, but at the same time, when he goes off and suicides, it's not worth 30,000. Okay, so how much is a spear? 6. Axe power 12. I can get at least one of those. Could I get 2? How much is 1750 times 2? I don't have enough for 2, do I? Well, let's at least... you know what? The next level might be one of those that forces you to replace. Let's get 1. Actually, let's get 2. Because 12 is a lot higher than 3. So I'm going to be really pissed if it forces me to pick up a different weapon. I suppose if I had this thoroughly memorized, I would know for sure. Call me lazy. This is the last area. Okay, this is the weird thing though. The axes won't break breakable blocks. Which can be a problem. The fireballs will break the blocks, but kind of slowly. And you can see there's some maces up there that I could grab, but it's like, I'd rather not, thanks. And at least I can pass them up. Ooh, got me. Watch out for the mushroom people! Here, we're replacing our... oh, we're not replacing our fireballs. Well, we got a heat-seeking little thing now. Ah, fucking mushrooms! This is my last... next to last life. I can't die on this shit. Alright. There's a breakable block. Takes a while without the mace, but... now, I can't remember one time I was able to access that. Oh, no, 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 you don't! Fuck! I'm okay. Everything's fine. Why would anything be wrong? This is just one of those games that gets you to swear in anger so well. Alright. I wouldn't go down there! Derp! Ha ha ha! Tricked me! Really? Are you sure that's how it works? You're making that up. But you could be right. Okay, so what do you think it is? To access that health, you need to pull the lever at the top without holding the key. Can I get back there? I don't know if I... ah! Jeez! Damn this game. Oh, okay. Too late to go back. They shut me out. So it's only the fireballs that are damaging these breakable blocks. There we go. Here's a really weird secret. Well, not a secret. so much as an instant death unless you know how to get avoid it. If I jumped up there to grab that gem, there are some monsters that also jump up there that you can't kill. And they have to hit you. And it's weird and it's rude and it's stupid. So the way you fix that is, see that guy right there is a thief. If we get out of his way, he'll go pick it up and he'll bring it back down, and then we don't even have to, and then he'll hit me in the head and I'm just fucked anyways. But then I don't have to go up there and be obliterated. It's like, wow, that's obscure. Oh, God. Not this. Use your trap keys wisely. Okay, this is just a total troll look. I'll grab that gem. No! Well, at least it's still down there. Maybe I can... Oh, no. Maybe I can go get it. Oh! Huh. Usually that trap door closes. I don't... That's weird. Whatever. So, oh, that hurt. We'll get some time bombs. Oh, yep, there goes. Ta-ha-ha, you got me. Oh. I don't know, do you think it'd be kind of fun, or do you think it'd be too obnoxious if they, like, had something cackling evilly when you, like, when they troll you like that? Ah. Now where? I don't even remember. Okay, we use the... Ah! Oh, thank you for the room sweeper when, after I've died. That's good. That's nice. Yeah, this game. Ah! Like, I get frustrated with it, but it's like, it's one of those things that's like interesting to see what they do. It's like, just like, wow, really, guys? And it's a fun game, all the same. Other than I get frustrated when I like keep fucking up on the minor details. I do not know how to get down there, and I spent quite a while trying to figure it out, and I never got it. To my great shame. Okay, this is super obscure. You have to lead these guys over here so that you don't accidentally shoot this. And then what you have to do is you can only shoot the top part. If you shoot the bottom part, you are screwed. So we shot the top part. And then we shoot every part except for that last part. And I've messed with it a little bit. This is the only way over. You have to kill that top part, and you have to kill the four parts other than this last one. Otherwise, you do not get any of that stuff, and it doesn't give you a second chance to, like, you know, bring the part you shot back. I don't think it's the room from the next level. I don't recognize it as anything else. But I have a feeling it's some really weird twitchy thing that, I don't know, maybe I'd even look it up. But it'll probably be like, really? That's what I do? Really? This would be a good time for that. I don't need any health. What does this do? Magic potion freezes aliens. Oh, apparently I'm fighting aliens. Well, of course, aliens invade the... I wonder if that's a translation thing. I don't know. Aliens invaded Mount Olympus because they look like little gray men. Okay, I don't want to go through that door yet because I'll be closed off. Okay, so you see that message down there? Pull hard left. I did this two or three times before I really got what it was saying. You have to stand as far possible as left as you can, which is one step this way. Let's see, I gotta face to the left first. Pull it and immediately run left. Boom! Like, wow. If I was facing to the right, it would take me too long to turn around, and I wouldn't get it. Wow, you know? These guys are hardcore. Treasure, yay! Oh god, this is the weirdest treasure room. You know what, I kind of want to save it just so I can get the whole thing. Nah, normally I wouldn't save it, but I do kind of want to explore. Well, I don't know. There's one spot where you pretty much have to pick up the maces. Maybe not. I don't know. It's weird, but at the very least, it makes it seem that way. See, like that mace. I don't have to pick that up. I don't even have to pick up that fireball. I probably shouldn't, to be honest, because I want these heat seekers. Come on, thief, die. So if I would have fallen any further than that, I couldn't get this stuff. Okay, you should play which game? You're not talking about this game, are you? Come on, break already! Am I even hitting it? I don't actually know. I've got to be hitting it. It looks like I'm hitting it, right? Okay, there we go. Wait, you played this? Oh, okay. Okay, so you know something then. That's cool. I can play it semi-competently. I've been to the end a few times. Well, a few times? Yeah, a few times. More than two times. Maybe not at first, because of the way it sort of demands that you, find the secrets for the money so you can buy power-ups. Not every secret necessarily, but you know, some secrets are worth a lot of money. Oh, no, I'm not gonna fall down there. Let's see. Oh. I don't know what the point of me getting this would be. Oh, that. Oh, and I've got the blue key. Yeah. Oh, I hate these guys. Die. Hey, bonus jam. And I just learned the other day what this thing does. Because as I picked it up, a golden aviary. It's like aviary, birds. Isn't there a part you pull a lever and it says something about birds? Well, you didn't know about it until now because you're young. Certainly no offense to Robopox, but I'll bet you he's a closer to my age? I won't say old. I'll be nice. Alright, let's move on. Bring the alchemist his tools. Here's a really weird... Whoa, God. Okay. Two lives, that's not bad, really. I hate these weird enemies coming up next are pretty bizarre. Flying fat men! I don't even know what that means! Ooh. See? Now did you see that? Since I had the genie lamp that said something about aviaries, release the birds. Now I've got a little familiar! Isn't he cute? Ooh, don't break that block. Or wait, no, I think I do break that block. I don't know. Get him, little dude. Okay, so... Nope. The only way to get up here is if you don't break any blocks at all. And I've done it by accident. Ah, those flying fat men! You know... See that? See? Did you see how suicidal my little pet got? And then he blew up. I mean, he takes some things with it, but it's like, I'd rather not have him blow up. Period. Come on. Crazy little thing. You know, it's much nicer having the maces so you can just breeze through these little breakable blocks, but, I don't know. These axes are super powerful against everything else. Against monsters, anyway. Yeah, you know what I noticed? I had the familiar at a point where there's some breakable blocks, and I couldn't break him because he wouldn't get low enough. He took the fireballs. Like, jeez. We need our gold bow. So see how I can't jump back up there? If I would have not picked up that gold bowl, it's screwed. It's just that simple. Is this what I think it is? Yes. This is obscure. I think this is another point where you can get permanently stuck if you do it wrong, because you need that thing there, that mortar and pestle. If you kill the enemy before it brings it over to you, well, you needed it, so fuck you, game over. Like I say, it doesn't say game over, but after you play for half an hour and realize you can't get anywhere, it's like, oh, okay, I guess I'm done now. Careful. Oh, yes, yes, yes. Gotta hit the lever. Be careful, that thief can help. So I don't want to shoot him. I'll put out a potion, so the attraction potion, so he'll come over here. I'm fucked. He picked up the wrong thing. I don't know why he picked up the wrong thing. He absolutely did. And now I can't get out. Why did he pick that other thing up? The game will give me an alternate solution. So am I permanently stuck here or not? Because this door will open once you have the mortar and pestle, but it won't open otherwise. Okay, play with the levers. I've done that before. Really? Trapdoor key. Ay, this game. Okay. Wow. Okay. I shouldn't have given up so soon then. Wow. You know what? Then you can get the mask too. I always wondered how to get that mask. But how can we pick that up instead of the mortar and pestle? Like, I don't get what triggers him to pick up one over the other. There we go. Okay, if I pull that lever, I fall down and I can never come back up. So we'll hit the secret button so we can go into the treasury. First time I played, I did not get any treasure. Thanks for the hint, by the way, because, you know, I mean, I guess I could have loaded a save state, but it's like, that was sort of far back. I don't think it matters if you break all these blocks. Jeez, come on, guys. Come on, don't take forever. There we go. Free guy was behind that. Oh, come on! You're killing me, game. You're killing me. You think I got all the time in the world? This feels like a 9-to-5 job now. There we go. Thank you. I think that it really is it. So, we'll go ahead and fall down. Well, that was the first. This is like when I played Zelda the other day, or what was it, Zelda 2 for the NES. There was a guy that was watching that just happened to know a lot about it, And I was just wandering around aimlessly, and he's like, well, you gotta go here, and you gotta go here, and I was like, oh, shit, dude, thanks for showing up, because this was gonna be my stream for the day, is walking in circles. Oh, I shouldn't have jumped. Oh, the slow block breaking. This game was interesting in how it kind of trolls you and forces you to do certain things and doesn't tell you things in, that are kind of really important and you don't know until you've played for two or three times. I don't know, a lot of times I would think, ah, that's just a horrible way of doing business, but at the same time I'm kind of like, I don't know, so long as not every last game I play is like that, I can sort of get into it a little bit, you know? I can be okay with it. It was the same thing with, I don't know if anybody would recognize the name of this game, but it was the same thing with Hexen 2. Well, and Hexen, the first one as well. It had some absolutely mandatory secrets in every level. You had to find, like, for all the stuff that was obvious, you had to find, like, two or three secrets in each level before you could go on to the next. And I don't just mean, like, you got more money. I mean, like, there was a key that opened a door, and you just did not get to go through that door unless you found the secret. And at first, I was annoyed, but I'm like, well, you know what? 99% of the games I have are not like this. Like, I'll play this once in a while when I want a fix of something really different. I'm almost dead. I'm probably gonna lose a life. Oh, especially if I do that. Oh, especially if I do that. That's lovely. Over here. No, I think I got everything. I agree. There is no randomness to this game, so once you get it memorized, at least quite a bit memorized. Oh, and obviously I didn't have that memorized, or else I wouldn't just bump my head right against it. But yeah, you're right. It's not like it shifts things around every time. So you can play it pretty consistently once you really know where everything is, and that's kind of where the interesting bit comes in, because you play it a few times and get used to where all the stuff is and how it works, and then you're good. And that actually feels really good to play it that way. But I think that is a really, like, old-fashioned thing. I think game players today that are used to, like, oh my god, kids these days, they're like so coddled, it's ridiculous. Like, people will get mad if, like, they're playing, oh, let's say, like, Elder Scrolls, and they don't get an arrow pointer exact tells them exactly where to go, you know? And it's like, how would you know that? Like, in some cases it would make sense, but, like, a lot of cases, it's like that. Oh no! No! Am I trapped? Fuck! Okay, I'm not. I forgot about this part. Yeah, that spear, if you don't pick it up, you can't go on it. It's absolutely true, because, you know, you actually get a message that says that. Ooh. Magic mushrooms, go away! This is the last level, isn't it? I'm almost done. Are you still here, Cinder Ghost? Ah! Three lives, alright. I don't know. Man. Alright. Deep breath, okay. No, everything's fine. Nothing's wrong. That's cool. I was just gonna say, if you're around, I was gonna say this is the last level. So, it's almost over. Jeez, I think I can do it with three lives. Boy, that's a crapshoot. Sometimes I do really well on this last boss, and sometimes I just keep flubbing it. So, we'll see. We'll at least go down here and get the treasure. Or wait, did I? Jeez. What? Okay. There we go. Oh, die. Now, see, I didn't know about this the first few times I played. It was just the other day. I was like, wait a second. Could I? Trapdoor key, what else is it used for, you know? It's like, hit the secret button, and now that moves. I'm like, oh. Takes too long, but, ta-da! And yeah, that is one I figured out by myself. Like, I would admit to the ones that I looked up. I think I only looked up a couple because something about them was just driving me crazy. I'm like, I don't want to bother. So, I actually waited to pick this up until I got the axes. Because I don't know if this power-up makes all your weapons more powerful or only the ones you're holding. Like, if I still had the spears, maybe it would double their power to 12, and then I pick up the axes and it resets it. I don't actually know if it works that way, but that's what I'm wondering. Behind this door lies immortality. Okay, this is where I take a deep breath. Get centered, etc., etc. And honestly, the things that kill me in this level are his two I-beams. Of all the things that kill me, the things that look like the wimpiest things are the things that kill me. Okay. Let's go for it! Three lives is not bad, but it's not good. See, always like one hits me, and then especially if I'm distracted by those guys. And the only way to kill this, I got it. The only way to kill this boss is to kill the worms. Nothing else takes damage. Nothing else damages it. And the worms will instantly kill you if you touch them. And if they get all the way around that little loop, they'll absolutely hit you. There's no way to avoid getting hit by them. I don't think. Unless there's some magical thing that I didn't figure out. Ah, well, at least I got two lives. And it's almost dead. Ooh, gotta be careful. Yeah! Start to finish. No save states. Well, you know what, I did save one time, but I didn't actually reload it. almost had a safe state, but I didn't in the end. Bob. This is kind of a cool ending. Robopox, I don't know if you're a Super Nintendo fan of this game or one that played the Amiga version, but this ending is fairly different from the Amiga version. You'll see. Unless you don't know the Amiga version. Like, that's usually where the Amiga version ends. But now we got all this. The way to Mount Olympus lies open. You may now claim your place among the gods. Enjoy your life, it will last forever. I just like this ending. Well, you know what? So you know how in the intro it shows him putting on his armor and swinging his sword? That wasn't in the Amiga version, but also, like, I won't go on forever, but like, the Amiga intro music was completely different. It's actually pretty good and interesting. I might just load that up on YouTube. Just at the end of the stream, just for a minute, it's short, just to see it, because I dig the music. And actually, the Amiga version doesn't have music throughout the levels, it's just quiet. So there we go, I beat gods, yay! Now it's just starting over. Yeah, okay, you know it. Into a wonderful... let me see if I can find it. I'm going to quit this. Just give me a sec. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Let's see, what would I call that? Which one would it be? God, there's like three things I can click on here. Oh, fork things. 9 years ago? 8 years ago? Jeez. Considering how long it's been out, I guess 8 years isn't that long. Which one did I try last time? I think it was this one. Okay, hang on. I know it's dead air right now, but... let's see. Remove. Add. No, 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 no. Screen capture. Okay, where is that? Hang on. I'm getting there. I really, really am. Ah, there we go. I think this will be it.
Into the wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. Into the wonderful, wonderful. Into the wonderful, wonderful. Into the wonderful.
Any man may earn through skill and courage a single favor. If he will face the fear of the ancient city. And slay the four great guardians who have stolen our citadel. Hero stands before the gods and asks that... dot dot dot. If he fulfills their quest, he will join them as an equal. Only the hope of the hero's failure comforts them. I love that story. The warrior departs for the city of legends. Preparing to carve one more story on its walls. I just really like that intro. The Super Nintendo one is good with for the animation, but just this music, you know, and that little storyline. Let's look at the ending real quick. I mean, it's only gonna take a minute. Oh, I've already searched for this. Do we have an ending? Well, you know, I could honestly just, I don't think this will take more than a minute. We'll just load the long play and then go to the end. Recognize that dude, right? See? No music. That was new for guys. Whoa, look at... I like how he ducks there. That's crazy. ...22 lives. Something tells me somebody's cheating. Come on, 22 lives, really? You have destroyed the last great guardian. Reluctantly, the gods bestow upon you the greatest gift of all. Immortality. Collect your gift. I didn't get all those extra lives. That's funny. I just got gems. The way to Mount Olympus lies open. You may now claim your place among the gods. Enjoy your life. It will last forever. And so what will you do with this gift? Journey again to the city if you dare. This time, your task will be harder. Do you think the Super Nintendo does that? It does not say that for sure. I'm wondering if it follows that, though. I have no idea. Whoa, I'm kind of tripping out now a little bit. I kind of want to know. Yeah. Oh, that's no fun. Because that'd be awesome to do a second run that's, like, much harder. What was I? Oh, there's my Twitch channel within a Twitch channel within a Twitch channel. It goes on for infinity. Whoa. That'd be pretty cool if it did, because I would want to see what that second quest is like. Almost want to get the Amiga version on emulator just to check that out now. Ah, I'm so curious. I like this channel. It keeps putting in the new infinite loops in there. Wow, I played that for about... Did I really play that for like 2.5 hours? It didn't feel that long. I guess that's what games do sometimes. You play them and then you're like, oh, the day is gone. Oh, well. What are you gonna do? So, I should probably get going. I probably shouldn't even have played that long, but whatever. That's alright. That was fun to go through the whole thing. I guess Cindergus was here from beginning to end. So maybe she's getting worn down, but... Now, when did you come in, Robopox? Like, halfway through, so... It's probably a little more tolerable. Yeah, thank you. I don't think I loaded a save state at all. I don't like doing that, to be quite honest. The only time I would do that is... If it's a game I don't really care about, like, beating on my own, I just didn't actually use a save state in this one. So that was fun. I was glad. Thanks for hanging around while I was doing that. And, oh yeah, giving me kind of that one critical hint, you know? I was like, well, I'm stuck here forever. At least, you know, I didn't just be like, everyone can leave now, I'm done broadcasting. There's no way to get out of here. It's like, try the levers. It's like, oh, never mind, I'll keep going. it's just funny. But I think I am going to end it there. Feel free to follow the channel. It's pretty cool meeting someone else that knows what Gods even is. I figure I'm mostly just showing a crowd of young people that are like, why is that not even in 3D, you know? So, I guess there are people that are my age or close-ish that remember these kinds of things, so that's cool. Ah, yeah, I should go rest now. But wasn't that nice? So, yeah, thanks for hanging around. Follow me, whatever. Or check me out another time. I'm off, though. I'm off to sleep. And, yeah, I'll catch you all later then. So... Nah, thank you. So, you know what? I just realized... Oh, never mind. So I think everything's on a 20-second delay, right? Well, whatever. I'm basically talking to myself now. Ramblings of a madman. So, anyways, catch you later.